Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly and effectively emboss a logo or any other graphic onto paper. I provided a textured paper image that we'll use to create a pattern. You can download it from the link located in this video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you haven't yet subscribed to Blue Lightning TV, smash that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials and quick tips. To create a pattern of this textured paper, just go to Edit and Define Pattern. When you see this window for the pattern name, just click OK. Open a high contrast black and white logo or another graphic that you'd like to use for this project. To ensure that it's pure black and white, go to Image and Auto Contrast. This darkens the darkest pixels to pure black and lightens the lightest pixels to pure white. To get a result similar to mine, check your graphic's size and resolution. Go to Image and Image Size. Make its width and or height between 1500 and 2500 pixels. Its resolution should be 150 pixels per inch. The reason is that filter settings will have different results depending on the document's size and resolution. To get similar results as mine, set your graphic size within the parameters of mine and set its resolution the same as mine. Click the lock icon to unlock it and open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click any of the thumbnails to make a selection of its shape. Open back the Layers panel and press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the white background. Deselect it by pressing Control or Command-D. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can add filters to it non-destructively, as well as replace our graphic with another without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a new layer below it by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with the paper texture pattern. To do this, fill the empty layer with any color. I'll fill mine with white, and since my background color is white, I'll press Control or Command plus Delete. Double-click the thumbnail of the bottom layer to open its layer style window. Click Pattern Overlay. If it doesn't fill with a textured paper, open your pattern list and scroll to the bottom. The paper texture pattern should be the last one. Just click it to fill your background. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. The angle is 0 degrees and I'll make its scale 100%. However, feel free to adjust the scale, which will determine the size of the pattern. Make your graphic active and reduce its fill to 0%. This makes our graphic invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of the layer styles we're going to add. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, and the technique is smooth. The depth is 200%, and the direction is down. The size is 24 pixels, and soften it 16 pixels. Uncheck Use Global Light. Global Light makes the light source of the highlights and shadows of effects, such as Bevel and Emboss, Drop Shadow, and others, all correspond. However, we're going to add a drop shadow that we don't want linked to it. The angle is 155 degrees, the altitude is 37 degrees, and the gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is linear dodge, the color is white, and the opacity is 15%. The shadow mode is multiply, the color is black, and its opacity is 30%. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is multiply, and the opacity is 50%. Uncheck Use Global Light and make the angle 0 degrees. The distance is 20 pixels, the spread is 0%, and the size is 20 pixels. The contour is linear, and the noise is 0%. If your original graphic is sharp, We're going to blur it slightly. However, if your original graphic is already slightly blurred, ignore the next step. I'll go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 2 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.